There it is. What up, folks? My name's Alex, as you all know, Mr. Alex Tech. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the mirrors effect within DaVinci Resolve. It's a little bit niche. You won't want to use it all the time, but it can be used to create some really cool effects like that sort of title sequence you've just seen. So let's open DaVinci Resolve and I'll show you how to do it. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve and we're on the Edit tab. Now I'm going to grab my clip and just pop it onto my timeline. I'm going to show you what this clip looks like by default. Here we've got this cool, nice time-lapse of this city. Now it's quite a cool time-lapse as it is, but we just want to jazz it up with some mirrors. So we're going to open up our effects library, top left-hand corner, and we're going to open up our toolbox. Now you can either apply this directly to the clip itself, or you can use an adjustment clip. I always prefer to use adjustment clips, so that's what I'm going to show you in this video today. So we're going to click on effects. We're going to grab an adjustment clip. We're just going to drag it onto our timeline above our footage and make it the length that we need it to be, like so. We're then going to go to the open effects here, also in the effects library. We're going to scroll down to Resolve FX Stylize, and you've got mirrors. So give that a click, drag it, and pop it onto your adjustment clip. And then straight away, you should see something that looks a little like this. So what it's done is it's put a line right down the middle and it's reflecting our left side of the screen onto our right side of the screen. So now we can customize this and start to have some fun. So give the adjustment clip a click, head up to the top right hand corner and open up your inspector, and then click on the open effects tab just under there. And you should see mirrors. If it looks like this, just double click to expand the menu. Now there's a few options of things in here. The first thing here is this mirror placement. So individual allows you to place up to 6 individual mirrors. You can mess with them and you can combine them and you can do what you like with them. We'll come back to that in a moment. If we click on the dropdown, we've got rosette, which gives this rosette effect like so. And then underneath that, you've got controls. And from here, you can change the X position. So from left to right, the Y, which is your up and down position, as well as change the angle and the wedge width. So it's quite a cool effect. You can have some fun with this one as well. If we click on the drop down again, we can go to kaleidoscope, which gives us a kaleidoscope effect. Again, we've got similar controls. We've got the X, the Y, the center size, the angle, and the number of sides. So again, there's some fun to have with this one. You can create some cool effects. Now we're going to go back to individual because this is what we're looking at today. And again, very similar. You've got the enable mirror, just turns the mirror on or off. You've got the X, the Y, and then the angle. So we can just adjust the angle like so. So I'm gonna put this one to 90. We'll reset those. And straight away, that's really changed the look of this scene. So rather than being this time-lapse of this city, we've got this really cool duplicated effect, and it almost looks like a reflective lake. So I really like this one. I think it works really, really well with this footage. Now, if we wanted to add an additional mirror, if we come down to mirror 2 and just expand this, we can then enable mirror 2, and we've got another mirror to play with. So it's not just being reflected on this middle horizontal line, we've also got a middle vertical reflection as well. So we can just move that and put that wherever we like as well. Again, just to combine these to create some other cool effects. If that's not enough, you can come down and enable 3, 4, 5, 6, or do whatever you want to do. Now, one last thing to show you is I'm just going to disable my mirror 2. Just go to my mirror 1 here. There's a flip tick box. So at the moment, what it's doing is taking the top half of my footage and reflecting it down onto my bottom half. If I wanted that the other way around, so it'd take the bottom half of the footage and reflect it up to the top, we simply hit flip, and now as you can see, it's taking the lower half of the footage and reflecting up to the top half instead. And it's as easy as that.
And that's it, folks. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, thumbs up, comments or feedback down below. And if you're new around here, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, take it easy. See ya.
Like a news reporter. Boop, 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 boop.